I'm Bethany Duarte, Associate Editor of Hydro Review for Penwell, and here are this week's Hydro headlines. Starting off in the United States, House Resolution 267, also known as the Hydropower Regulatory Efficiency Act of 2013, has passed the U.S. House Energy and Commerce Committees. This bipartisan policy was submitted to the House just days before receiving the committee's approval earlier this week. The bill is a reintroduction of legislature formerly known as House Resolution 5892, which is designed to promote the growth of many hydro and in-conduit projects by streamlining the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission's permitting process for low-impact proposals. The bill received a unanimous 372-0 approval from the House this past July, but it didn't come to a vote in the Senate before the previous legislature session ended. Moving now to Europe, Belgian officials are considering a new type of pumped storage project to help the country wean itself off of nuclear power by 2025. The project would include the construction of a 3-kilometer-long, horseshoe-shaped island off of Belgium's northern coast. This horseshoe would have a 30-meter-deep reservoir in its center and a pumped storage generating facility in its open end, giving the complex a total generating capacity of around 300 megawatts. Officials say the project would be primarily used as a way to store the country's excess wind power and could be constructed within 7 years, pending further study. Now in Asia, a number of governments and organizations used the 19th Mekong River Commission's council meeting to voice their displeasure with the construction of Laos' 1,285-megawatt Xayaburi hydropower project. The commission was formed in 1995 to encourage cooperative development of the Mekong River through members Cambodia, Thailand, and Vietnam argue that Laos did not complete its due diligence before moving ahead with the Xayaburi project. The Laotian government even appeared to accept a proposal at this past year's committee meeting that put a 10-year moratorium on new dams on the Mekong River. Laos says it wants to become the battery of the region, however, and the Xayaburi is one of 11 projects proposed for the lower Mekong. And last, it's not too late to receive the discounted early bird rate when you register for HydroVision Russia 2013, but you need to hurry. The discounts apply to individual full conference registrations and corporate plans, but you have to sign up before February 4th to receive them. HydroVision Russia 2013 runs March 5th through 6th at Moscow's Expo Center. For more information about the event, registration, or to view a pre-show guide, visit HydroVisionRussia.com. That's the Hydropower News for this week. Watch for this newscast each and every week, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services.